This next palm is very nice in terms of flow. It's called the water palm. In the water palm, the I Ching says that the energy flows up and down just like a wave. The wave is flowing from one direction and then the next, sometimes like an undertow, sometimes like a very large wave lifting up and overpowering whatever it touches. In the water palm exercise, we hold the hand in this direction as it comes all the way up and circles out, like so. Be sure not to bring the elbow much higher than the shoulder in this position. Normally, we'd push forward a little bit more and leave it just about shoulder height. If you do it like this, you'll want to do it as a stretch, but you won't want to use that as an application. In the water palm form, we'll drop the hand down, flowing. Now look at this from the side. In the fire palm, it dropped. In this one, it flows. So as it flows up and down, we use it in the exercise like this, dropping the weight and flowing, lifting and flowing. Just get the connection between the legs, the hips, the waist, and the arms, all as one thing. Using it here, down and up, down and up, down and up. This is shifting the balance. See, coming into a tiger stance, and up, down and up. I want to mention that you can practice all of these palms in the various stances. I'm simply illustrating them here in these so we can see how to get the connection. Down and up, down and up. It's important that we get this connection. If we don't get the connection, then just simply walking in a circle, as most Bagua people will do, or walking in a linear fashion, or fighting, if there's no connection between the body and the palm, then there's no power. There's no power, the art is not effective for fighting. Let's look at the application of this. Terry, will you help me, please? Okay, if we put Terry here, again, we'll put him in this framing position like this. The water palm is up and out. Now, if I simply try to lift him by doing this and pressing up with my shoulders, it's very hard, golly. It's hard to do because this guy's heavy, okay? So if I use the legs coming up like this, then I roll the arms underneath him. You see how it starts to lift them? And the legs are doing this lift. So in practicing, I just lift coming up. That lift gives me a nice upward rolling action. Now, should his hands be a little more loose, then it'll lift him way up. You can come down and do all sorts of controlling applications to him. Here again, let me remind you, we're only showing this as a practice, not as a martial technique. Obviously, you're not going to do this when somebody attacks you all the time. Let's look at the Tai Chi application. One up, one down. Again, this arm is used flowing downward like water towards the side of the waist or the crease in the hip, which is called the gua, flowing down here. The other hand will be used on the other side. We'll turn around so you can see that. This one's coming down. This one will be flowing up this way. Now the energy will be curving from my leg upward into his body like so. So when we do this, right about here like this, okay, this one comes down. This one will then flow up like so. And this will be the end of the posture somewhere in here. Okay, that's the way the water palm will work. Play with a friend and do this. I want to say this again, and I'll say it throughout the tape. Don't force it. Don't use hard energy. Just relax and feel. Feel where his energy begins to break, and then add your energy. Don't try to fight against his force. Never, never do that.